Hi guys, I'm Sonal and welcome to my channel. Today I'm making a sweet recipe. I almost always make savory recipes, and today I wanted to make something decadent and sweet. So I'm going to make a cream cheese stuffed French toast, which is sugar free obviously, and then top it with some sugar free syrup. So let's go ahead and make it. So I'm making the egg mixture to dip our bread. I've taken a square pan just so that it makes it convenient. One egg. I'm adding about 2 tablespoons of thick cream. So this is like, there's hardly any water in this. So if you put it in the fridge, at least the cream here will separate and the water can be taken out if you want, or you can keep it in. To this I'm adding a tablespoon of the hazelnut syrup, Turani. Since our cream was thick, we can afford to add liquids. This is what the mixture looks like. So this is the bread that we made yesterday, and I put it in the fridge. So I'm going to dip it in the egg mixture, then fry it in some salted butter. So our pan is hot. I'm going to put some butter. Sure, I'm dipping the bread. Smelling wonderful from the hazelnut syrup. It's got a brown color on the other side. I'm going to flip it again because I want to get the brown color on this side too. Okay, get it out in the second slice. So let's make the stuffing for our French toast. This is going to be a cream cheese stuffing with some hazelnut flavor. So the cream that I buy in India, sometimes the water separates like that, and I am going to get rid of some of the water. So there you go. To this, I'm going to add about 1 tablespoon of erythritol. I have cream cheese here, so this is about 1 tablespoon, and I'm going to add 2. This is enough for 2 big slices of bread that I've made at home. And you know, you can add any kind of flavoring. You can add maple syrup or honey if you're eating sweet. On keto, you could crush up some strawberries and add that to the mixture. I'm going to warm this up a little bit in the microwave and mix this, trying to get all the lumps out as much as possible. To this I'm adding some hazelnut syrup, and it's going to make it a little sweeter, as well as it'll give it some hazelnut flavor. So this is 1.5 teaspoon. And our filling is ready. So look at how smooth and creamy it looks. And I think it needs a couple of drops of stevia. So I'm adding those. I'm gonna put it in the fridge and let it sort of get a little firmer, because our French toast is going to be warm. So you don't want this to be too runny, because when you put it on the French toast, it'll just slide off it. So I forgot to start my camera. What a shame. What I did was, I took one layer, on top of that I put my cream cheese stuffing that we had made yesterday, and we put that and we sandwiched it between the 2 French toasts. On top of that, this is some of the leftover cream cheese filling that I scooped out and put, and I topped it all with some raspberry Turani syrup that I have. You can even add some fruits or berries to this.
You can add some blueberries, strawberries, you can crush those and even mix it in the cream cheese filling and then fill it into the toast. But this is good enough for me. So all done, and take a look at it. How beautiful it looks. Now it's time to taste. My French toast is ready and it's time to taste the best part of the video. Finally, a guilt-free dessert to eat. Look at it. This is too good. I can't stop eating. I had to stop the camera, finish the whole thing, and then re-record. Trust me guys, it really turned out good. Yesterday when I made the bread, I could taste a little bit of egginess in it, and that's the reason I put a generous amount of hazelnut syrup in the custard or the egg mix, and we also had the raspberry syrup on top. And today in this French toast, you could not make out that this wasn't bread. It was just that it was a little thinly sliced compared to a normal bread, and a little bit of, it's a little different probably, but you know, to me it almost tasted like a dessert or an authentic French toast. And especially with the raspberry syrup, I love the raspberry syrup, it is really good. I wish I had got a couple of bottles extra, but no harm done. You know, give this recipe a try. You can try it with whichever syrup you have, any sugar-free stuff. You can even add just vanilla essence and your erythritol or any sweetener that you like, and make a syrup out of it. I'm so glad that cream cheese is available in India now, and I'm going to make this more often with different flavors. Give this recipe a try and let me know how it turned out for you. And write in the comments about your experiences. Like my video and subscribe to my channel for many more videos like this. Thanks for watching. Bye.